5 habits that you need in 2021. What is going on, everybody? Zach Grana here, and today I want to talk to you about 5 things that I think everybody should be doing in 2021. The whole COVID thing and everything has been so unprecedented, but these are certain habits that have helped me keep my mental and physical health in check, so that I can still function and enjoy my job and find joy in the things that I do. Things are starting to look promising as the number of vaccines goes up and the number of cases for COVID goes down, but these are still things that I have found really, really useful to me this past year and that I will continue to do even after COVID is over. The first habit is to wake up early. This has been a game changer in my life. Honestly, I used to tell myself that I was a night owl, I was not a morning person, you know, type thing. But being a morning person is a choice. Once I made that choice, it literally changed my life. I noticed that from the hours of like 10 p.m. to midnight, I would never do anything useful with my life. I was always too tired to actually do any work, and I just would be on my phone or Instagram or watching TV or a movie and just never did anything useful. So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna go to bed at 10 and instead wake up at 6 and then have those 2 hours in the morning. And having those 2 hours in the morning has absolutely changed the way that I feel. I used to feel very lonely during the hours of 10 p.m. to 12 a.m. because no one else was awake and I was just kind of by myself. Those 2 hours in the morning are just a completely different feel. I have so much more energy. I have so much more hope and expectation for the day. So from a mental health standpoint, I think it's really, really helpful to wake up earlier in the morning. Secondly, waking up early gives me a chance to center myself, fully wake my body up, and then set my plans for the day. I'm gonna make a video going over this in detail actually next week called My Morning Routine, where I talk to you about how I make my to-do list, how I accomplish everything I wanna get done through the day, and how I maintain productivity. But overall, just simply the act of waking up earlier has helped me a lot with that. The second thing is to meditate every day. I have so many thoughts going through my head all the time, and meditation is a skill and a refuge that I have learned to come to calm myself down and to quiet my head. Meditation is actually a skill, and it's something that I continue to get better at. I would definitely not consider myself an expert. An expert would be a monk who's been meditating for like 40 plus years, and I am not there yet. I am not able to just shift into meditation mode and turn off my thoughts really fast. It usually takes me a long time, but providing myself that space allows me to have a lot more mental clarity when I make decisions, when I go about other things of my day. And it's also helped me be more aware of my thought patterns and know when I'm slipping into self-doubt and gear myself back into self-love. The third habit that I strongly encourage everybody to pick up that I picked up because of quarantining is to read every day. I made a video a while back on Atomic Habits talking about how that book had changed my life and how I'd been implementing things that I'd learned from it into my day-to-day practice. But there have been so many other books that I've read over the course of the past 9 months that have literally changed the way that I think about and see the world. And it's so cool to see everything from other people's perspectives, especially people that are extremely successful in their fields and learn to mimic the behaviors that they have done to be successful. So reading these books has given me a lot of energy, a lot of purpose, and I strongly recommend you guys start reading books. So I've actually linked 5 of my favorite books down below if you want to start there. And that leads me into the fourth point, which is to get outside every single day. I have a rule for myself that I need to step foot out of the house at least once per day. With quarantine and with my job being entirely online, I theoretically don't have to leave my house ever. But being outside is so good for me. It literally elevates my mood in seconds. It makes my body feel so much better. I know I've told you guys this many times, but I love going for a morning walk because it wakes me up, it gets my blood flowing, gets my mind thinking. So I love a morning walk, but if you don't want to do a morning walk or that's not feasible to you, I urge you to get outside at least some point during the day. I love hiking personally, or if you like biking, or I don't know, jogging, surfing, any of these activities that get you outside, it's gonna be really, really beneficial to your mental health and to your physical health. Getting that sunshine on you, the vitamin D, will actually boost your mood as well. So strongly, strongly recommend that you get outside. If you live somewhere cold, you might be like, Zach, I can't just go outside when it's like 20 degrees out. Fair enough, okay? But I think you should still get outside. If you have to wait till the afternoon, till it's warmer out, fine. If you have to put on a jacket, fine. But please get outside at least once a day. My fifth and final piece of advice for you is to find some sort of creative outlet that you can do every day. For me, I have three different creative outlets. The first one is lesson planning for my students. I love creating fun activities and games and things to play with them so that they can learn the scientific concepts in a fun way. So for me, that is a huge creative outlet. Another one is playing piano. I try to play piano at least once a day. I also love composing on piano, and I actually have an album linked below if you guys want to check it out. My third creative outlet is editing. Actually, editing videos is a huge creative outlet for me. I love the joy I get from putting the music together, editing the cuts so that they flow with the beat, and just adding text and making fonts that look really cool and pop up. Doing all of these things is a source of creativity for me. I'm creating something and I'm putting it out into the world. And there's this sense of satisfaction that I get when I create something that's hard to describe. I think you just have to try it to understand what I'm talking about. But for you, it might be artwork. You might like painting or drawing or sketching. I don't know, something artistic. I'm not very much of a artsy, like drawing type person. I prefer like talking and videos and music. That's just my way of expressing myself. But find something where you can fully be you, fully express something that you care about and are passionate about, and create something for the world. You don't have to share it with the world. Like, I know I put my YouTube videos out for the world. You don't have to do it like that if you're not comfortable, but just creating these things has a very cathartic effect. It is a very healing effect, honestly. So create more. That is my fifth and final piece of advice for you. I hope you all found this video helpful and enjoyed it. If you did, please smash the thumbs up button to let me know. As I said earlier in the video, morning routine will be coming out next Sunday, and the week after that will be my nighttime routine, because I think those two videos kind of go hand in hand. Bodybuilding journey is going great. I'm gonna keep updating you guys with that every Wednesday. It's a lot of exciting things in the works, so I will keep you all updated as always. Don't forget to stay hype, always better every single day, and I will see you in the next video.